Now we are studying arcing phenomena of circuit breaker. So let us assume we have one circuit breaker connected to the system like this. This is generator and this is the inductor and this is the capacitor. And this is the nearest substation and a circuit breaker is attached like this. A circuit breaker is attached like this. And this is the line going forward. So what happened basically, when we do not have any kind of fault, this circuit breaker contact will be closed. When this will is closed, so during closed condition, during closed condition, the voltage across circuit breaker VA will be equal to 0 volt basically. So now when the relay senses the fault and gives signal to the trip circuit, so that it will give a signal to the circuit breaker so that it will start separating. When it is start separating means when this is just about to open. So when it is just about to open means like this. So when it just about to open, there is a voltage difference occurs between the contact of them. So that is VA will not be equal to 0 this time when this will be open, and this time the value of D will be equal to very very small, so that the dielectric stress occurs between the contact of them. So delta V is nothing but the dielectric stress occur between them. So dielectric stress is equal to delta V by delta D, means this is equal to VA upon D. So VA D value is very small, so that the dielectric stress will be very very much. So when the dielectric stress will be very very much, so that when dielectric stress value, when dielectric stress is greater than dielectric strength of the material, then arcing phenomena will start. When dielectric stress is greater than dielectric strength of the material. Let us go into detail. So what will happen? We know that the dielectric stress is written as V by D means we can say electric field. When the contact separates, then there would be a voltage difference between them and there is a distance. So electric field energizes the electron here, so that when number of more electron will be present here and moving in the medium, so that arcing will start. Means if electrons moves in conductor, that will be called as current. But when electron moves in medium, that will be called as arcing. But the condition should be this: dielectric stress should be greater than dielectric strength of the material, then electron moves in medium, that will be called as arc. This is the same condition here. So this is how the arc is starting in the circuit breaker. So arc is starting in the circuit breaker due to electric emission theory. And what happened after this, once the arc has been created, then it will ionize the nearby atom with the help of temperature. So with the help of temperature, so nearby atom will be ionized and produces electron. So here it will be thermionic emission. So basically initially what happened, thermionic emission, basically what happened that with the electrical emission theory, electron has been generated and thermionic emission theory, the electron has been sustained, means arc is initiated because of electrical emission theory and it is sustained because of thermionic